Hey friends, it's me, it's your old buddy, Dexo1, and I'm here with the Super Indie Karts beta, cause Super Indie Karts it's not actually out yet. I'm not sure when it's due to be out. I don't think it's even on like early access or anything like that. It might be on early access. I will check, and I will put on the screen now whether or not it's on in early access or not. Anyway, this is a game I backed a while ago now, and they gave me a key which was for the alpha, which then turns into the beta, which I would hopefully assume turns into the full game. As you can see, time trials, not quite got that. I mean, it's not unlocked yet because I assume it's not finished. But yeah, I'm playing this game because I've seen some people kind of let's just do hard because I mean I know kart races, but like I'm not super familiar with the tracks or cars or how it handles or anything like that. No, yeah. I've seen, ooh, this is gonna be good. Let's just do this for now. I've seen some people kind of looking at this game called Poppy Kart, and basically that whole game is like a direct rip-off. Like it's a rip-off where they've just like recolored the sprites, basically. Of Super Mario Kart, you know, that's super not cool, and I'm like, you know what, I should show off this game, which is not a direct ripoff of Super Mario Kart. It's more Super Mario Kart inspired, which should be more of what they were going for. So the big thing about Super Indie Karts is that you got all these indie games, man. Look at these, it's Guacamelee. You can play as the guy from Guacamelee. The robot dude from Oz. Turing from Read Early Memories, which is on desktop on my two playlists. I'm pretty sure the kid from Teslagrad is supposed to be here. Maybe I've not unlocked him yet, but we're gonna go with Mutt from Lobo Destroyo, because that's a game I'm really looking forward to, which is basically like a Banjo inspired game. So you gotta do the inspired games, you don't just rip them off anyway. So like, yeah, as you can probably see, this is much better than that other game where it was basically a direct ripoff. It's much nicer looking. It's a lot cleaner. I imagine it probably handles better. Music's pretty good. And essentially, it's essentially Super Mario Kart, you know, but on the Steam. Probably with online multiplayer eventually, I would hope. Oop. And of course, like, oh, what was the button to use items? Is it that? No, it's not that. Is it the trigger? No. Is it B? No. No. Oh, there it is, I found it. It's a left trigger. I know Mario Kart 8 has got, oh damn, third, that wasn't very good. I know Mario Kart 8's got like online multiplayer, but you know what, not everyone has a Wii U. And also Mario Kart 8 is not Super Mario Kart. Oh, there we go. And some people maybe want to play some Super Mario Kart together, you know, it's a good time. I would also go as far as saying that maybe this game is a bit better than Super Mario Kart, because I don't know how many people have gone back and tried to play Super Mario Kart, but like, it hasn't aged very well. That's a red shell. And to the same extent, oh man, I like the music in this level. To the same extent, Mario Kart 64 also, that has aged poorly. Really poorly. Oh shit. Oop. Didn't mean to do that. So yeah, you can drift. If you do it properly, you can drift. Oh. Oh, it's got that kind of like wiggle backwards and forwards. Oh, you just have to drift for a long enough time, I guess? Yeah, there you go. Oh, alright, yeah. So the tracks, I think, not this one, but like, maybe not this one? But like, a bunch of the tracks are like, based off of the games. So like, I'm fairly certain there's a Neo San Francisco track based off of Read Only Memories. I'm really excited to play that game, by the way. After the big, like, high of Undertale. I'm kind of coming down off of that very slowly. I'm still like listening to the soundtrack and stuff because man, what a good soundtrack. I did good on that one. Oh man, that's not so good. You just went ramming into the wall there, Lobo. What are you doing? Mutt, sorry, Mutt. Mutt, his name's Mutt. Yeah, I'm slowly coming down off of the high of Undertale. I'm still like, you know, I'm still gonna keep telling people, you know, oh, I guess these tracks are based off of. How do I get the booster? I wonder. I haven't quite got there yet. What? I'm still obviously people who have not yet played it. I mean, again, jealous of you people. What was that? I'm obviously going to advise people who have not yet played it, and I mean, I realize some people are kind of holding off of it until the initial hype dies down to see like whether or not, you know, it's a good game in its own right and people aren't just like, whoa, oh man, people aren't just like riding off of other people's hype, and you know, I get that. But yeah, I will still advise people to play that game. Such an incredible game! I'm talking about Undertale in this video still. I've made like 2 Undertale videos on my channel at this point, and it's like, hey, haven't you talked about Undertale enough? No, never. Never. Legitimately is like my favorite, like one of, it's now like one of my favorite games ever of all time. Forever. God damn it, what the. Yeah, this game's, definitely a kart racer. I think there was a, I saw an option somewhere like turn off the 3D walls, and I'm like, wait, does that mean it gets rid of like that safety? Nah, Jesus. Oh. Oh man. Yeah, that's what I said. What the hell was that? Some character just like went at me. What the? What's the deal? What'd I do to you? Yeah, I'm coming down off the. I've repeated this sentence like 5 times now. Coming down off the hype of Undertale. It's a good game, but I'm not. I'm now looking at what are they? Oh shit! I fucked that one right up. What other games are out there and are. Oh, shouldn't drive into the fire. That would be a good idea. God, I keep saying I was about to say it again. That's why I'm sighing. I was going to say it again. Jesus. Fuck it. I'm looking forward to seeing like what other games that are like coming out around this time. I'm going to be like, of course, I'm going to get into, god damn it, read-only memories. A lot of people said good things about We Know the Devil, which I've still yet to purchase. So it's not like on Steam or anything, it's on like its own, it's on its own platform where you can buy it. I can't remember what it's like Date Night or something like that, so weird like that. And there's another game that's like recently just come out like today, like a few hours ago, in fact. It's called like Downwell, and it's on like Steam and iOS. And that looks like the jam. Like, that looks fucking awesome. Like, if that turns out good, like, to be really good, and I can, like, really get into it, and I can really get the hang of it, like, I'm gonna get it, see how it is, because it's, like, only, if I remember rightly, it was, like, a ridiculous price, like, $1.99? Which, I mean, makes sense, because, like, App Store games are always, always super, super cheap, but that is a ridiculous price for a game that looks as good as that game does. I mean, it's still like, oh man, I really did not win at all. What rank did I get? F. Very good. I'll do another one. One of these places has got like Neo. Oh, that's it. That's the one. Yeah, look, there's the Tesla Grad track. So you must be able to. Oh, Duck Game! Freedom Planet. See, it's got all these cool. Rumbo as well. It's got all these cool. Oh, these are just like your standard cups, alright. I'm gonna play this one. And I'm still gonna play this mutt. Oh yeah, Downwell looks just like. Is it there? Do I? Not quite. Downwell looks like a. It's just like a like an 8-bit. Huh? Oh. So, I have to actually jump over those. Okay. It's just like an 8-bit thing, but it looks like it's like super fast moving. Trying to think of another game to compare it to, but I'm currently coming up with a blank on that one. Whoa! Alright, okay, that's, yeah, That's fine. Whoa! So yeah, it's been a long time since I made one of these. Fuck. I've not recently really had the time to sit down and like just play a bit of a game and then like upload it afterwards and be like, hey, check out my fucking video of me, god damn it, fucking up a game. Usually that I've not previously played. I have played this once before. But that was, I think, back when it was still in the alpha stage. It seems to have definitely improved a lot since then. I can't really. Oh, that was the Duck Game. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. That was the. Yeah. I have played this game once before. They definitely seem to find some things. Out. Freedom Planet is a game that I've not played. How the hell do you get that boost? I'll work it out eventually. Probably not in this video, but I'll work it out eventually. What the hell? What the hell was that? That's rude. Ugh. Oh man, why'd I do that? That was not a good decision that I just made. So yeah, I haven't really had the time to like sit down and really make one of these for a really long time. Like, I've barely had the time to even do my Let's Play stuff, which is stuff I'm like really trying hard to focus on. Not currently making a lot of it currently, because Vile's come down with the illness. He's come down with the sickness, as we say usually when one of us gets sick, because it's a funny haha joke, everyone gets the reference, we all have a good laugh, and then we go on with our lives and forget that we haven't said anything, so it's all good, you know? Dang it. Those things are a nuisance. I made a mistake picking this cup, I think. I picked it because it had the Neo San Francisco in it and it looks cool. Ah, shit. And also Duck Game. Did that guy just apologize for hitting me? Dude, that's like not the point of this game. The point is like win. Yeah, he's like apologizing. Man, I'm doing absolutely terribly on this. Yeah, apologizing's not the aim. You're supposed to mercilessly beat the opposition until you win. That is the point of kart races. I very much doubt that I'll be able to get like my friends to kind of get on board with this game and play it with me. It would be nice to get some people together and maybe do like, oh shit, like a group video, and maybe upload it to the VNDLP channel, but I don't know, we'll see. I'm definitely gonna end up covering this game on that channel anyway, because of secret stuff that I cannot really go. I mean, I guess I could go into it here, like, probably very few people who are subscribed to VNDLP. Actually, yeah, like, way less people who are subscribed to me are also subscribed to VNDLP, because, like, I have, like, 200 subscribers, and that's, like, overall since I opened this channel, like, 2006 or 7. Jesus Christ, this is an old channel. And I still don't really know what I'm doing with it. Trying to figure something out, but fuck. Yeah, the idea. Oh man, I did it! Ram into that wall, yes. Yeah, the idea, so Mutt is from, as I said before, he's from a Banjo-Kazooie inspired game, which I kickstarted along with this game. The reason why I kickstarted this game and Lobo kind of at the same time. What is Ronbo? I've seen it on the Steam store like a couple times, but like, I've fucking no clue what kind of game it is. What is happening? What the f- Oh! Alright! Shit! Dang, that's- Okay, Jesus. Oh man, oh dear. Oh shit. Wow, yeah, this is new. I don't remember playing this track before, because I would definitely have remembered that. Motherfucker, damn it. I think I jumped into that one. I'll get the hang of it eventually, I hope. Oh man, that is maybe a little bit obnoxious, I want to say. Or maybe I'm just bad. That's probably more like it, is that I'm just bad. Oh, okay. Yeah, see, this is the kind of stuff you get from me when I've not played something previously. I'm just like all over the place, like, what's fucking happening, man? Ah, Yeah, that last place. Yeah, straight in a hole. What was I fucking talking about? Oh yeah, so sorry for swearing. Yeah, so the reason I backed this game and Lobo together was because they kind of did like a joint thing. I think the developers know each other quite well. And, yeah, I'm not even on the fucking podium there. Man, I did poorly. I'll do one more. One last one. This is the last one, I swear. Let's just start off with the easy stuff, you know? Whoops. No. Oh, well, I guess I'm playing as that guy now. So, yeah, I think they did, like, a kind of a... Oh, I got it! They did, like, a kind of a combined sort of backing effort where they kind of both promoted each other, and if you backed Lobo and this game, there was, like, exclusive content that you could get if you backed both games and you had the proof to back it up that you backed both games, and I wanted that stuff. It's kind of maybe a little bit... Fuck. Saw that one coming before it fucking even hit me. It's kind of a little bit questionable, I guess, being like, oh, you... Oh, God damn it, those fucking pineapples! It's kind of a little bit questionable, maybe, doing that kind of thing, like, exclusive content to people who spend even more money outside of the money that you are giving to us. But at the time, I was not really thinking about that. I was more kind of focused on, oh man, a new game that's like Banjo-Kazooie. And this is like way before the ukulele Kickstarter. This is back in like 2013, 14? One of those. Yeah, look, there he is, Tesla Kid. I must just not have him unlocked yet. And so I backed both games because I wanted to get the stuff. Alright, yeah, no, that's not the way to go about things. I have to say, I'm not really noticing much of a difference in how this guy controls over Mutt. I'm kind of wondering, like, are the different character choices just like an aesthetic thing? Because usually with kart races, like, depending on what kind of racer you choose, like... What the fuck was that? Did you guys hear that noise? I might actually boost the volume for that because that was magical, but I may not need to because it was so fucking loud. Oh, this game's silly. I kind of love it. So yeah. I was like, oh man, a new game. It's going to be like Banjo. I want all that shit that's gonna come from that. And I also may have given that Kickstarter a bit too much money. It helped them fund their goal for sure. The amount of money I gave them, I almost lapped those guys. Well, there was a guy there at the back almost lapped, but yeah, so that was a Lobo Destroyer, and that's why I backed this game, Lobo Destroyer. So the plan is, okay, the plan, I'm just rambling, but fuck it, that's what this video is. It's me rambling over a video game. That's what you fucking clicked on this video for. The plan is to, like, let's play Lobo Destroyer when it comes out, and, like, it may not come out. I don't know, man. Like, that game's been... Shit, those are not real walls. That game's been in development for a little while now. And there was, like, a bunch of stuff that's kind of hindered their development. Like, they were supposed to get a bunch of money from Ouya? And then they didn't, because Ouya pulled all their, like, indie backing stuff, and that sucks a lot. And meant they had to reduce the scope of the game, and that was, like, really sucky. But the game's still coming out, and it's still gonna be pretty good, I think. At least I hope. I gave it a lot of money. I really should stop, like, just seeing Kickstarters for games I really want and just going like, yep, just throw all my money at that, that's fine. Think about the consequences later. I make too many decisions like that. I've really got to be better about that, because a lot of it's like money related stuff, and it's like, hey man, maybe think a little bit. Like, nope, just all my money. There it goes. Well, it's too late now. Get out of the fucking. Ah, damn it. Anyway, the plan is to let's play Liberty Destroyer when it comes out. Maybe next year sometime. It could be either before or after Ukulele. Part of me wants to say it maybe might come out afterwards, but maybe it might come out just before, which would be really good if it came out just before, because then I could satiate my banjo thirst on Lobo Destroyer just before Ukulele comes out. That would be good. Very good. And I get an overdose of banjo style gameplay and maybe die, because I've finally gotten what I have been after for like fucking 15 years I've held a candle for Banjo 3E, and you'd think by that point I would give up, but no. Never give up. Banjo is too important to give. No, it's really not. Banjo is really not that important to have fucking wasted so much of my life just being like, when's that game coming out? Really should have taken the hint when it didn't come out like a few years after, and then, how the hell did I manage that? And then fucking Nuts and Bolts came out, and yeah, well, I don't need to tell you about that. You know all about that, yeah. If you're watching this video, you probably know all about that anyway. So yeah, the plan is, let's play a little bit of Destroyo. As well as Ukulele, let's be honest. And, you know, fucking fill the channel full of just stuff that's like Banjo-Kazooie that I've been waiting for years. And be like, hey, isn't this fucking great? Did I get first place? Did I win? I won! Yeah! That's the shit! Right there, what rank did I get? That's right. That's right. Anyway, I'm gonna fucking finish this sentence and then finish. How did I manage that? I'm gonna finish the sentence and then finish this video. Go away. So let's play Liberty Destroyo, and then this game is gonna be like a bonus video, cause like Lobo's in this game as well. So it's just like when I did the Banjo Kazooie Let's Play way back when. And like had ended up playing Banjo Pilot and the original Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing because Banjo was in both those games. So that's what I've been trying to say this whole time, is that this game's probably going to come up again on VNDLP because Lobo, not Lobo, Mutt, is in this game. And Lobo Destroyer is going to be a game that I do a Let's Play of eventually. So that's the secret VNDLP secret that you can know if you... I'll subscribe to this channel. Anyway, I'll probably be making another video tomorrow on something. Don't know what. I'm definitely going to buy Read Only Memories and play it, and Downwell and play that, and We Know the Devil and play that. There's a lot of playing to do. Got a lot of catching up. I've also got like tons of games that I've been putting off finishing. I've been meaning to make a fucking Mario Maker video since it fucking came out. Yeah, there's a lot of different stuff, videos on stuff I want to do. I probably do more reviews. The Undertale review was fun, so I'll do more of that. There's gonna be like stuff on his channel, man. It's gonna be good, and I hope you all like it. All right, I'll see you later. Goodbye.